from the home than a white child. So for over 70 years, African-American children and families have been mistreated in the foster care system. What makes it so bad is that foster care is not a good parent. It has been a pipeline to prison, homelessness, and results in generational recycling back into the foster care system. In San Diego, in Central Region, 9% of the population are black children, but 23% of cases are open. In East, 5% of the population are black children, but there are 16% of the cases are open. North Central, 4% of the population, 16% of the case open. North Coastal, 4% of the population, 6% of the cases open. North Inland, 3% of the population, 9% of the cases that are open. South, 3% of the population, 8% of the cases are open. All regions have a disproportionate number of African-American children. And it's disappointing, it was very disappointing to see that the chair of the review committee did not make this an issue of disproportionality since he has served on the Fairness and Equity Committee. My recommendation is that the county amends this report of December 4th to address the issue of disproportionality, and that additional oversight be required at the assistant deputy director level to ensure that African-American children's numbers coming to the system are reduced. This process has been monitored for control of Polinsky population and also determined to regarding evaluating our referrals. Surely African-American children life matter. If not to child and family strengthening advisory board, then definitely to the community. We are committed to taking whatever step is necessary to eliminate the factors harming African-American children in a system that's supposed to be set up to protect. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Bevelyn. I just want to comment briefly on your remarks. So that initial child welfare report provided the initial recommendations of this body, but we're not bound by the recommendations that were made there. Or limited to the findings of those. Our task really is to take those along with other groups and other input and other feedback from other stakeholders. We met with a lot of folks who have shared your concern that there were things that were not in there that they would have liked to have seen in there. And that really is the task of this body is to add those. And the disproportionality issue you raise is important. And it is recognized as an issue, and it is something that we are going to work to address. And so I take your concerns to heart. And just know that this body will be working on that in an effort to try and address it. So just because it wasn't in the previous report is not binding on this body that it's not important to us. So I appreciate you being here, and I appreciate your continued advocacy on this.
And I do hope that the report will be amended to address it. The goal has to be to eliminate disproportionality. And Nick has made that commitment and has done his part to help us. And I thank you, Nick.
Great, thank you.
I apologize if I'm not gonna say your name correctly. Zucina? Was I close?